Gamer.
Welcome back, sports gamers, to part two of our exclusive interview with creator Mike Mendheim and lead developer Ivan Zaplava of Mutant Football League Dynasty Edition. Now, if you missed part one of our talk, be sure to go check it out by clicking the link in the description below. In part two, Mike and Ivan talk about more testing features within the game's Dynasty mode, as well as the game's sales goals. So, without keeping you waiting anymore, take a listen. When it comes to, you talk about adding something late in development, how difficult is it to, when you see something that, oh, why didn't we think of that, or you get an idea, how difficult is it to implement a feature like that from a development standpoint? Ivan, this is more directed towards you.
Sure. Well, it's very difficult if you're not ready for this, but I work with Michael for 2 years now, and I know that it happens all the time, and that's why we develop in a way that you can take all those new features at any point of time and implement them pretty quickly, and at least to check the prototype. I think it won't break anything else. So if you're ready for this, if you have experience with such kind of development, like flexible, agile development, it works fine, I guess. So it's not that bad. As I said before, it's not more about development itself. It's more about balance of that feature, balancing that feature and testing that feature, and all those small details that you can see only after first feedback from real users, real people. And so that's why you always need some guy not from your team to play your game in this new feature and get feedback from him.
Do you, when it comes to franchise mode, Mike, you mentioned it, franchise mode is a beast. You've seen, there's been countless of other smaller titles try and put out games with a dynasty or franchise or career mode that just seem to come up short. Did you when you were deciding and designing this, did you and the team just look at past smaller developers' iterations, or did you just go from a clean slate and like, this is what we want, so let's figure out how to get it done? Or did you take inspiration from elsewhere?
Yeah, no, I mean, I look at like the main sports games that I play, right? And then I look at some classic sports games that just are beloved by, you know, the world to play sports games. And it's Mutant Football League, right? So it's an arcade action game. It's not a sim. And we've never said, even though the game plays really awesome and there's good AI and there's, you know, you will be, you know, when you play against somebody, you will be screaming and all of that. It's still an arcade action game. So we didn't want to go like too deep into the woods on our franchise mode. We wanted to give everything that you kind of want in a franchise mode, but we tried to, you know, keep things fairly simple. Mm-hmm. So it's not like you're going through pages and pages of statistical analytics. I mean, we have stats, but I mean, they're very kind of like basic stats. I mean, we have individual player stats and we have team stats, and you can see who's leading the league in rushing and all of that stuff. But we're not a simulation. I mean, our game is supposed to make you laugh, and it's supposed to throw curveballs at you and always kind of be unexpected. So like in our dynasty mode, we're doing like things that have never been done in other dynasty modes. Like in our dynasty mode, you might get a message from the owner that you know, one of your players is held up in a Dunkin' Donuts and he's got the whole place held hostage. it's going to cost you this much money to get him out. And if you don't pay it, then you're going to lose him for, you know, 5 weeks because we're going to have to go do a legal trial. And then you got to decide what you want to do. And if you pay the money, then you get him back. And if you don't, then he sits in jail for 5 weeks. So we have stuff like that happening in our dynasty mode. But what's really cool is when you start dynasty, I mean, your team sucks. You have a 40 rated team and it is bad. So as you go out and play, like, you get whomped, right? But you could trade for some really expensive players and make your team instantly better. But it costs you, like, in the long run, because you have to manage the team's budget. Or you can go out and just start stacking up some XP, right? And our XP is based on fantasy football. So, like, you get a 1 point of XP if you're a running back for every 10 yards. You get 6 points if you score a touchdown. So it's very intertwined with how fantasy football points work. So then as you start adding your XP to your players and your players start meeting certain goals, like your running back ran 50 yards, you know, we always give you like these player goals. You start, like, the players start getting better and they actually physically like start changing. They get bigger and tougher. And, you know, if you gut it through like halfway that first season, you start winning some games. And if somehow with a couple of smart trades or pickups, you can get into the playoffs, anything can happen in the playoffs. And then as you continue through multiple seasons, your team just gets stronger and stronger. And then obviously the teams you play against, we have that all balanced. So it's always interesting. But your team, like, now can stack up with some of the premier teams in the league. And what you're trying to do is win multiple Mayhem Bowls so you can become a dynasty. And if you don't do good, I mean, you get fired.
Do you have a – obviously, the goal is to have as many players pick up this game and play it as possible. But is there a goal in mind that you're looking to achieve to really go – to really tell yourself and tell the team, this was a rousing success?
Yeah.
I hope so.
Yes. We have internal goals. And while we didn't quite hit those on the first go around, we're hoping that we hit them on this go around, right? We think our product's pretty awesome. We think we have a complete game with a lot of depth now. We're across all systems. We're not having a staggered launch. We're having a simultaneous launch. And, I mean, I'm very proud of the product. I'm extremely proud of the team that built the product. And, you know, I just hope the game players that like arcade sports games give us a shot, and I hope we can continue making these types of games.
I have a couple more words about game design and about your question.
You asked how
we come up to with game design, and I would say, frankly, it was so natural because I think, like, every fan of Mutant Football League knows how to make this game look great, because they wrote down so much feedback for us, what they want to see there. And what we did is just combine it, all that feedback, and it was Dynasty, you know, like all those features, like almost, I would say, 80% of features that we created was from feedback from different people from our community. So it's, everyone knows what they want, and we did it for them. So it was very easy.
So there you have it, sports gamers. The full interview with Mike Mendheim and Ivan Zaplava of Mutant Football League Dynasty Edition. After hearing everything you've heard, do you think the Mutant Football franchise will see another release? What about a Mutant League game of a different sport? Let us know in the comment section below, and be sure to subscribe to Sports Gamers Online and hit that bell to be notified every time a new video goes live. And don't forget to visit sportsgamersonline.com.